is like multiple mini funerals for all of the people dear to my heart that I've lost in TV shows / video games / movies. It's called Remember Those Who Have Fallen. The first one, anybody that watches The Walking Dead, Dale. Yeah, he has a last name. I didn't know that until yesterday. That's my name is Beach. He died on March 4, 2012. It was Carl's fault. Carl, there was a zombie in the woods, and Carl was like playing with him. He's a freaking idiot kid, wants to play with a zombie. And then after he left, the zombie was like, oh, he went that way. So he got out of the mud and followed him, and eventually killed Dale. Which is sad, because Dale had hilarious faces and was like the only sane person. Sarah Lance.
No.
Anybody that watches Arrow. By the way, spoiler alert for shows, if you're not caught up, that's
I think you just destroyed Grayson.
No, I'm caught up.
He knows.
Almost. I'm one episode behind.
We share the pain. She died October 8, 2014. She was known as the Canary. It was a name given to her when she joined the Assassins. It was Malcolm Merlyn's fault. She's not the one that killed her, but it was his fault.
Oh.
Yeah.
So it was pretty awful because she survived a boat wreck and all kinds of other stuff. It was painful. Madeline Weston. This one hurt pretty bad.
Oh, what?
This was the first show that I like religiously watched every single week as soon as it aired. There was no downtime. Like I watched it right away.
Oh, crap.
She died on September 12, 2013. I remember it was a Thursday.
I remember I was on the show.
Sorry, Grace.
I was in my bower room. 2:32, freshman year. I was sitting in my little bungee chair. Sad moment. This is Michael Weston's mother, and she blew herself up, that thing, to save her son and his friends, and also her little nephew. Yeah, her other son, who had also died, had a son. And then, it's a real confusing story. It's my nerd side, the 11th Doctor. He died May 18, 2013. He was my favorite. As everyone knows, bow ties are cool. It's because of that guy. So he regenerated, which is a thing they do. In his case, he didn't really like die. He was just getting really old and got a new regeneration cycle. So he's like, I'm pretty old. I'm going to go ahead and regenerate and kill all of these evil things around me. It was literally everything in the entire show that was trying to kill him. He was in a town called Christmas. Yeah, isn't that awesome? They're like, oh, where am I? It's Christmas. He's like, I know, where am I? Like, no, the town's called Christmas. It's a joke you would tell, which is pretty cool. all of his pictures look like this, so there's really the only two off of that for a picture. I'm really sad that he's not here, but my respect for Simeon Moore has died. I wanted to tell him that he sucked. That Taylor Swift was perfect. Yeah, have you ever seen his shoes? They're just kind of ridiculous. Like, my grandmother wears his shoes. Like, she has all these awards, and he wrestles at Southeastern. But we can't prolong that because he's not here to make fun of him. Beth Greene, anybody that's not caught up, it's getting closer and closer.
Yeah.
Thank
you.
She died on December 1st, 2014. I remember where I was in that one. I was also in the same bungee chair. I was just in Destino, room 207. I had an ice cream bar in my hand. The second she died, I got so mad, I yelled something very obscene and threw the ice cream bar against my wall. And if anybody knows Dion Colbert, me and him had to clean that up after. He didn't have to, but he did. He was a really good guy. There was no reason for her to die. There was just an idiot cop named Don. Worst character in the show. Even worse than Carl when he killed Dale. And she just shot her. It doesn't make sense. Rest in peace, Beth Greene. Sarah Miller, this one's a video game.
Oh, is this?
This is from The Last of Us.
It's the
opening scene. So she died September 27, 2013, which is amazing because I thought in a video game it would be whenever you played it, but there's a Last of Us website. That's the day she died specifically in the game. So that was pretty awesome they had that. And it took me forever to find her last name. Because video games don't really have last names. This one did after some research. She was the daughter of Joel Miller, which is the main character in The Last of Us. It's a post-apocalyptic game. She was shot in the stomach when her and her father were trying to escape the city. They were like, there was a zombie behind them. They were like, they were trucking it. So they're like, oh, frick. And, you know, they don't know what to do yet. And so this military guy comes out and shoots a zombie. And he's like, oh, and they're like, whoa, chill out, people. And then I guess his, like, commanding officer was like, no, you have to kill them. So he was like, no, don't do this. And then he, like, turned, and when he shot at him, they shot her in the stomach. But then his brother came up and shot the military guy right then. It was pretty cool. But then it was literally the saddest death I've ever seen in a video game, because it was just prolonged, and she was crying. It was miserable. Yeah. Highly, highly recommend the game. Fantastic. Best game I've ever played. Pawns. Oh, also from Doctor Who. They were the best. No one knows when they died, because really weird thing in the show, there's things called weeping angels, and if they touch you, they send you back to a random point in time, and you just live to death. Like, nothing happened, they just send you back in time, and you're just there, so you just live your life until you die, like a regular person. So no one knows when they got sent back to, which, I mean, they probably knew from, like, newspapers and stuff, and then they could have wrote it and been a little courteous, but instead, Rory died, and then I don't know how she went 5 years without him and then died, because he was like 3,000 years old. Like, it's a long story. But he was pretty old because he was like, it's complicated. Anyway, that's Amelia Pond and Rory Pond. Anybody that's not caught up on The Walking Dead, I'm not sorry for this because I told you to catch up like 2 weeks ago. But Ray, question mark. We're not sure if he's dead. Like, people are 100% sure he's dead, and there's people 100% sure he isn't dead. If he did die, it would have been on October 25th, 2015. This scum of the earth, Nicholas right here, who tried to kill Glenn once already, and he killed Noah, which was absolutely awful, no spoiler alert. Nicholas shot himself, and when he did, he was falling, and Glenn was like, no, and like for some reason grabbed the dead guy. And when they did, they fell off of this dumpster into this pile of zombies. But Nicholas like fell on top of him. So the zombies started like eating Nicholas, and then Glenn is like, ah, and is like freaking out. And at the end of this last episode this week, Daryl's driving, so Daryl's still alive, guys. He's driving in his truck with Abraham and Sasha. I hate Sasha, I wish she would have fallen up there, but. So he's like, hey, is anyone out there? And he talks on the radio, and someone comes back like, help. And they're like, oh, frick, is that Glenn? But we don't know. So we're going to find out this Sunday. I really hope it is, because he has been there. One of the two characters has been there since the first episode. Hmm. Like, he was physically there, but he was on the radio in the first episode. And he was, like, right at the beginning of the second episode. So he was there since the first episode. And it was crazy, because this guy was just shot himself right on the dumpster. Both. But anyway, those are the people that I've lost. Except this one. I don't know. Might not have lost them. But that's my wish.
That's beautiful. It's very touching.